The National is coming right up, but first, let me tell you what's on CBC this Sunday. It's the world premiere of Sex Traffic, an explosive new film about the dark and gritty world of enforced prostitution. Sex Traffic begins this Sunday on CBC. And next Sunday, Wendy Mesley launches The Greatest Canadian. Find out who made the top 10, and remember, vote for your favorite. I'm Nancy Wilson. Please stay tuned for The National.
That accident involving the Canadian submarine Chicoutimi claims the life of one injured sailor. We'll have the details next on The National.
Hi, Helen.
Dreams. They're the heart and soul of every financial security plan. Share yours with a financial security advisor from Freedom 55 Financial. The freedom to choose, the power to get there.
Think renovating will bust your budget? Your mission, to save. Run to Rona for the Rona Top Secret Scratch and Save event. Saturday, October 9th only. Save 5 to 25% on everything in each and every Rona. Just look for your Scratch and Save card on your Rona flyer. Hurry, this offer will self-destruct at store closing time. The Run to Rona Top Secret Scratch and Save. Saturday, October 9th only. Make it happen with Rona, the how-to people.
Hi, just having a look at your transmission. When was the last time you changed the fluid? You want to protect your warranty.
Time to visit the fluid experts at Mr. Lube for a quick, convenient transmission fluid change and a 21-point visual inspection.
Of course, you probably check this owner's manual all the time.
Mr. Lube, doing it right by the book.
You may not get a bill from the underground economy, but you definitely pay. Each year, under-the-table cash deals in the construction industry cost all of us $1.3 billion in lost tax revenue. That's equivalent to 20,000 new hospital beds or 79,000 post-secondary opportunities. Not paying taxes robs us all. To find out how to help fight back, go to www.undergroundeconomy.ca. The underground economy. It's like having your pocket picked.
For more than 50 years, the team at Diomino has been the region's most trusted choice for the purchase of windows, doors, and kitchen cabinets. That's because for renovations or building brand new, our incomparable selection fulfills all styles and meets all budgets without ever having to sacrifice quality or design. Theomino products are manufactured on the spot to precise specifications by 100 devoted and highly skilled workers. Theomino, three locations to serve you better. Massa-Angers, Hull, and Gloucester.
We're doing pretty good. We're both working.
Yep. But in a few years, we want out of the city.
We don't want to keep this pace going forever. We want to travel. We want to relax.
We need some kind of plan to make it happen.
And that's why we called you. You guys can help, right?
Yeah, sure we can.
At TD Waterhouse, we listen so you get the right plan. TD Waterhouse.
Tonight, a Canadian lost.
We pay him our profound respects and his family our deepest condolences.
A sailor dies of his injuries as his disabled submarine drifts in the sea off Ireland. Opposition strategy.
We're not going to be patsies or pushovers in the Parliament of Canada.
The Conservatives rip apart the throne speech and propose their own agenda. Smoking up. It seems Canadian high school students lead the world when it comes to using marijuana. And summoning the dragon.
This is an unforgiving world where a series of little mistakes can quickly accumulate into one big one from which there is no recovery.
The maiden voyage of Chicoutimi's sister. Close quarters and close calls on a Canadian submarine.
The National. From the Canadian Broadcasting Center, here is Peter Mansbridge.
Good evening. An emergency in the North Atlantic has turned into a tragedy. A Canadian sailor has died after a fire on board.
Last spring, you swamped us. In this two-hour special, we reveal your top 50 choices, counting down the list until only your top 10 greats remain. Then the battle begins. Over the next 6 weeks, you will be asked to choose from that top 10, the greatest Canadian of them all. Are you on the list? Well, it helps if you can tell a joke, sing a song, recite a speech, invent something, or shoot a puck. And, Mr. Prime Minister, if you're watching, congratulations. You've shaken hands with several people on the list. One thing we want to make clear is that this list has not been fiddled with by CBC to promote its talent. That being said, you can see number 50 on CBC Monday nights.
We'll rant and we'll roar like true Newfoundlanders.
On behalf of the young people of Canada, Mr. Martin, let me be the first to thank you. Ya big tool.
He's ranted his way to number 50 on the list by leaving politicians silenced and us laughing hysterically.
He made fun of all the big issues in Canadian politics, and I think that in a way got Canadians too a little bit more interested in politics because he came at it from a fun approach.
Everything. Pepper. Yes, of course.
That would be pepper spray. Do you have that in the spray?
Sometimes I heard more about that than anything I've done in public life. I will go to a political meeting. They won't talk about my speeches. They will talk about the hamburgers and the soft drink I had with Mercer on TV.
We demand that the government of Canada force Stockwell Day to change his first name to Doris.
I think that that was just a wonderful way for Canadians to voice their opinion about Stockwell Day. And I remember when those emails were going around, and I was definitely one of the million or so people who voted for Stockwell Day to change his name.
Listen to me very carefully. When it comes to running countries, it's very important that the lesser of three evils wins. If the most evil wins, that's not good.
I think when you're looking at greatness, you have to take the sum total of a person's life and works. You know, he's funny, witty, far too young. And I think he'd probably like me saying that.
Rick showed us that we like to laugh at prime ministers, but we respect them too, putting 7 on your list. If you can't wait to see which ones made it, maybe try a crystal ball. It worked for this guy.
Fortune teller, can you see what my future's going to be?
If you were making a list of leading great Canadian loons, Mackenzie King would probably come quite near the top. He was a very nutty fruitcake.
We know that because he kept a diary. That's where we found out that he always made time for his dog and his mother, even after they were dead.
It seems so long, Willie.
Is that you, Mother?
We're all here, Willie.
Fortune teller, will she stay?
The advice from the afterlife must have helped. He held on to power for 22 years as Canada's longest-serving PM.
Time has come when to save our Christian civilization, we must be prepared to lay down our lives for its preservation.
You look at a picture of Mackenzie King and you think, what a dull, boring-looking little toad he is. But you live for power. Only out of necessity will you ever make a decision or any kind of change. And only when you have to make a change, then you'll do something.
If not our greatest Canadian, he may have been our greatest procrastinator, like when he dodged Quebec's opposition to wartime conscription.
By the end of the First World War, there was so much hostility to conscripting French Canadians to fight in what they saw as a British war. We didn't get to conscription in the Second World War until almost the end. Hardly any conscript saw battle. He kept this country together. That's one thing that's important enough to put him on anybody's list.
Number 48, Canada's first Top Gun. The cocky ace who shot down 72 German planes in the Great War at a time when the life expectancy for a rookie pilot was 11 days.
He was good at it, and he was ours. And he loved the publicity, and he went along with it and stimulated it.
Get another machine ready when this one cracks up. Happy landing.
He was a very good pilot, and he just loved shooting people down. It's a daring thing to do, and to be reckless makes you feel more virile.
Faith in me brings me to tears.
Some of his claims of German kills later came under scrutiny, but Billy Bishop gave a vicarious thrill to a nation used to being known as, well, a little dull. And he did his bit again for his country in the next war as Air Marshal.
His founding of the Empire Flight Training Program, that probably turned the course of the Second World War, supplying the necessary personnel to carry the air war to Europe.
I want to know where I stand. I want to know where you stand, too. That's what I want to know.
My fellow Canadian. I'm a Westerner, and I fall into the category of, I don't necessarily think he was great, but he was sure entertaining. Think of him as the Mel Lastman of prairie politics.
This is a time for greatness in Canada. The raising of a vision.
Number 47 came from Saskatchewan to be elected prime minister with the largest majority in Canadian history, even sweeping Quebec. How likely are we to see someone from Saskatchewan doing that again anytime soon?
My fellow Canadians, I speak to you tonight as leader of this nation.
I don't consider John Diefenbaker to have been a great man. He's remembered, I think, more for the political victories rather than what he achieved as prime minister. He is remembered for killing the Avro Arrow.
The Avro Arrow has become a multi-million dollar make-work project.
You really don't understand, do you? You know, it's politicians like you who would keep this country from greatness.
He's sort of seen sometimes as a fusty conservative, but actually, one of the things he did that no other prime minister had ever done is he gave Indians the vote in 1960. Diefenbaker changed the law and allowed Indians for the first time ever to vote. And in fact, my husband has, I think, a John Diefenbaker statue on his desk that he bows down and worships every day.
If you want a lover, I'll do anything you ask me to.
Number 46 is a poet turned singer-songwriter from Montreal who made depression hip.
If you can sell your anguish, then you've probably done one of the best possible things you can do with anguish.
And turned his poetry into landmark songs of lost love.
Suzanne takes you down to her place near the river.
For those of us who grew up in the 60s and lusted after, you know, handsome, angry young men who were, you know, Jewish and intellectual and sexy and wrote beautifully. I mean, he was it. He was like the it guy.
Oh, my love. Oh, my love. Take this waltz. Take this waltz.
I think it was in grade 10, an English teacher of mine played some Leonard Cohen songs as examples of poetry, and we looked at the lyrics and studied them as poems, and I think that, you know, I mean, he's an amazing writer, and I think that it's wonderful that he's on the list.
I used to think I was some kind of gypsy boy.
I think he's a famous Canadian, but I don't necessarily think he should be on the list. I think he's had a tremendous influence in the music world. He's certainly a great singer, a pretentious poet, but they all are. And as a novelist, man, if you can work your way through one of his books, whew, more power to you. I think he's a great Canadian singer-songwriter who can't sing.
You know, it's only in a country like this that I could get the male vocalist of the year.
Us into thinking of him as a little guy from Shawinigan with a humble aw shucks style.
You have a very funny way of serving pies these days.
In fact, he was one of our shrewdest prime ministers, with, shall we say, a steady grip on power.
Who the hell is this guy who talks like the French-Canadian lumberjack from Bugs Bunny?
He was our leader for 10 years, which is quite remarkable when you consider that much of the time, we had no idea what he was saying.
Oh, that's good that I am happy, you know, to be on the list. It is an honor, and mainly I'm happy that other guy didn't make the list. I love this country, because that's always how he finished his speech. I love this country.
It's what I call leadership, to inspire the people, to challenge them to go to higher peaks.
Jean Chrétien, he's a really great man. You know, I went in there thinking, okay, I'm going to meet a politician. And I left there realizing that I had met a wonderful Canadian.
Vive le Canada! Vive le Canada! Vive le Canada!
His passion for Canada helped him win the 1995 Quebec referendum by the comfortable margin of the skin of his teeth.
Jean Chrétien was a good politician, a very good politician, a wily politician. And in many ways a very good prime minister for Canada, particularly with the political times that we have gone through in the last few years. In terms of greatness, I'm not sure that he had a vision for Canada.
I remember how Jean Chrétien refused to simply align himself with the U.S. when they decided to go to war.
Canada will not participate.
That was a very smart and courageous thing to do. And for me, that was a moment that I was incredibly proud to be a Canadian.
What do we want?
Peace!
Where do we want it?
Now!
And he went around the globe and he said, we want the coalition of the willing, and I was not a willing. And we were not a willing, and the Canadian took a lot of pride in that.
He's the only living prime minister on your list. Next, who'd have believed that only six women would make your top 50? The first is coming up next. Sorry, Roberta. Sorry, Margaret. We'll be back in a minute with a really surprising choice.
The Greatest Canadian is brought to you in part by Subway Restaurants. Subway. Eat fresh. And by Air Canada.
My mind just won't shut down.
It's been diagnosed as a muscle strain.
Internal lacerations, bruising.
Go, 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 go!
I don't care if I'm hurt, whatever it takes.
For many, Tuesday will be a wake-up call. For some, the end of the dream.
I want to be out there so bad.
I'm definitely here to be the top six.
We want to be really aggressive.
Back in, back in!
He's got major league speed.
Come on!
The falling players are on the bubble.
I got to figure out a way to outdo everybody else.
Your cut.
Making the Cut, presented by Bell. Tuesday on CBC. Brought to you in part by Samsung.
How great is this? Just me and my delicious Subway sub. No distractions, nobody bugging me. This rules.
Rush into Subway restaurants and try our tasty sweet onion chicken teriyaki sub with 5 grams of fat made on our fresh baked bread.
Nope, doesn't get any better than this. A man and his Subway sub.
It's made with tender strips of teriyaki seasoned chicken breast, a tasty sweet onion sauce, and your choice of fresh veggies.
On second thought, it would be nice to have some company. I wonder if anyone would like to sit and talk subs.
Subway, eat fresh.
An RBC Avion card is the travel rewards card that actually makes it easy for you and your family to fly. Yes, and we're offering 10,000 bonus points upon enrollment, plus double points until August 31st, 2005. As far out of town as you'd like. RBC Royal Bank. First, for you.
The new 2005 Special Edition Nissan Sentra comes loaded with more. Like a 100-watt CD stereo, power windows, door locks and mirrors, remote keyless entry, air conditioning, and of course, more fun. The Special Edition Nissan Sentra comes loaded with more of everything. Visit your Nissan dealer for limited time lease offer.
A legendary actress.
Everything's so tedious. I want something to happen.
A handsome admirer.
Remember that young chap I introduced you to? Young American. Good-looking fellow.
Vaguely.
An ambitious starlet.
I'm putting you under contract.
with platinum and peroxide, there's no lack of blondes these days.
Hers is natural.
I wonder how you know that.
Annette Bening, Jeremy Irons, Being Julia.
In select cities, October 22nd. Everywhere, October 29th.
Okay, audition in 2 weeks. Whiten your smile. No red wine, blueberry pie, coffee, tea.
Got it.
Imagine a dental plan that makes you look incredibly polished. New Crest Vivid White Toothpaste. It can give you a noticeably whiter smile in just 14 days because it helps polish away stains and helps prevent stains from returning.
Good advice.
Crest Vivid White, part of the Crest Dental Plan. Healthy looking, beautiful smiles for life.
When major events happen,
putting together a cabinet is a question of skill and regional balance.
Canadians turn to CBC News.
There's a harrowing story.
The source Canadians trust. CBC News, The National, weeknights at 10.
Your list of the top 50 greatest Canadians is full of surprises. Here's one of them, number 44. Mary Maxwell, great Canadian, household name. No? Doesn't ring a bell? She was a high society girl from Montreal who married the head of the Baha'i religion and became Madame Ruhia Rabbani. She traveled the world spreading the Baha'i message of peace and tolerance.
The youth of today are beginning to come out of this valley of materialism.
There are 30,000 Canadian Baha'is, and it seems a good number of them hope to promote that message by voting for her.
Love will keep us together.
The first French-Canadian Prime Minister was totally dashing and eloquent, devoted to French and English Canada getting along.
I have been branded a traitor to French-Canadians and a traitor to English-Canadians. I am neither. I am a Canadian.
He passionately promoted the idea of one Canada, not two.
Laurier is one of my personal favorites. When he said, je suis Canadien, at the beginning of the 20th century, it was a genuinely revolutionary statement.
I want the marble to remain the marble. I want the granite to remain the granite. I want to build a nation which shall become the admiration of the world.
The great thing about Laurier is that he was a consensus builder. And in a country at that stage, at the turn of the century in Canada, where you had an English and a French side, you needed somebody who would bring people together and not divide them.
Laurier the dandy blazed the trail for Pierre Trudeau, and Laurier the survivor appealed to Jean Chrétien.
There was a lot of fights about the Rutledge, and it was dividing the nation. And here was this Francophone, French-Canadian Catholic, you know, who was running the Liberal Party of Canada, who stayed there as long as he wanted. He had a good trick. He always offered to resign, and they would ask him to stay.
Sir Wilfrid is still very much around. In Ottawa, he's a hotel. In Waterloo, a university. And on our $5 bill. That's not the Queen on a bad hair day. Sir Wilfrid is one of six sirs that you put in the top 50. Two of those sirs were knighted for their scientific work, including Sir number 42. Back in Sir Sanford Fleming's time, people used to set their watches according to the sun. Almost every city had its own time. When the railways came along, the schedules were chaos, which disgusted Chief Railway Engineer Sanford Fleming.
Between Halifax and Toronto, there are five different time zones. It's ridiculous.
Clearly, the crankiest character ever to appear in one of those heritage minutes, he came up with a plan to get the world's clock synchronized, standard time.
There's a great Canadian. He changed the world. He created the whole concept of modern time zones. The world operates efficiently because of a Canadian. So he deserves to be on the list.
Who can take the sunrise?
Who can take the sunrise?
Sprinkle it with you.
Light, camera,
action.
Just one girl. You want to get ready?
We were shaking and shaking.
Coming from Toronto's famed Second City, John Candy's characters range from the guy with the snake on his face to half of the Schmenge brothers' polka duo.
Hello, I'm your Schmenge.
And pretty well all of them were friendly and good-humored in sort of a Canadian way.
John Candy would be on my list of greatest Canadians because I think he had the wonderful and distinctly Canadian qualities of being funny and humble. And every time I look at John Candy, he has the power to make me kind of well up and laugh at the same time. That's a really hard thing to achieve.
Oh, Gord, you're gonna love it in Toronto. They got roads and everything there. All kinds of roads.
And jobs, too?
Lots of jobs. Doctoring jobs and lawyering jobs. Jobs for me and you!
He looks Canadian. And I'm not talking about the fact that he was kind of overweight and a big guy, but he looks Canadian. He seems like the type of guy who would go fishing and the type of guy who would go hunting. And, you know, he looks Canadian.
Given his choice, John Candy probably would have lived in Canada. But if he was going to further his career, he had to move to the United States. But still, I saw him as a Canadian in America, as opposed to a Canadian who went to America and became American.
You had to find it endearing when he took some of his Hollywood wealth and influence and bought into the troubled Canadian Football League, just because he liked it.
John Candy was a great Canadian. But to put him in the category of people who've really shaped events and consciousness, he didn't have the time to become that. Unfortunately, I believe his life was cut short.
Oh, I had talent. I had talent. I had more talent in this little finger than in this little finger.
Who says young people don't want to vote? They sure turned out for number 40. At just 20, she's the youngest on the list, and at 5'2", the smallest. He was a boy, she was a girl. She took a raunchy attitude, some catchy rock licks, added your dad's old tie, and became an overnight pop icon. What more can
I say? She's sort of this angry young woman, this cocky kind of anti-fashion chick who really has become famous for her own particular brand of fashion. She does have a sense of style that's pretty unique. I mean, I'd say give her 20 years before she really qualifies as a great Canadian.
Don't you have to be like legal drinking age to be great? I don't know. She's very famous. She's in the news all the time. She's a little punk-ass girl. She wears a tie over an undershirt, which I guess is kind of cool. But does that make her great? But, you know, a million 8-year-old girls can't be wrong.
In this polite nation of ours, there is only one hitman on the list, Bret Hart, a real Canadian hero of a fake sport.
And I just want to dedicate this match to all my fellow Canadians.
He was one of the biggest names in the then World Wrestling Federation, so there was bad blood with boss Vince McMahon when he decided to leave.
There was this situation that unfolded in Montreal, and he was betrayed by Vince McMahon. And immediately afterwards, he did something which registers with Canadians in a way that very little does. He punched Vince McMahon in the face.
Drilled him. As hard as I could.
And it was this act of boldness that we as Canadians love, in particular because he hit an American.
They were trying to ruin me, just to ruin me kind of thing. And I think Canadians took a personal, like it bothered them that they were trying to do that to me.
Go get him, champ.
He sort of seems to have these stories that happen to him and sometimes not so good things that happen to him, and yet he pushes through and continues on, and for such a big wrestler, kind of dude-looking guy, I mean, he is such a gentleman.
Wow. I'm surprised Bret made the list, and I guess it's just that wrestling's already, you know, I guess, you know, if Super Mario Brother was Canadian, he'd have made the list too, you know?
Well, we do have a Super Mario, otherwise known as Mario the Magnificent. First hockey player in our countdown, he's beaten nearly every opponent he's faced. In 2002, he captained our lucky Looney team to Olympic gold and kept the streak going with the 2004 World Cup.
A lot of people say that Had he not gotten injured, he may have gone on to beat Wayne Gretzky's records, and some people can debate about who was the better hockey player, blah, blah, blah.
Sure, he's a magician with a puck, but does that make him a great Canadian?
No hockey player belongs on this list. He gets paid millions of dollars to play the game. He gets the cheers of the crowd. He plays the game that he loves. From every standpoint, when you look at it like that, Mario Lemieux is in it for Mario Lemieux. Not a criticism. That's what you're supposed to do in business. But it doesn't make you a great Canadian or the greatest Canadian.
But we love a comeback tale. And Mario Lemieux is hockey's cat with nine lives. He came back from a back injury and Hodgkin's disease to show he still has what it takes to be a champion.
I think when he gets something like Hodgkin's disease, it sort of brings him down to that reality that, you know, a lot of young kids, unfortunately, in our country, and a lot of people, they suffer with cancer. So they can sort of look at him and his story and how he survived, and he can go back and play hockey, that, you know, maybe I can survive cancer too.
Sets it up, score!
I just love the game, so that's why I keep coming back. And every time you can come back from serious injuries or illness, it's got to inspire some people, especially people who have been in the same situation as I've been. I think it is a great honor to join all the great Canadians over the years.
The American government is concerned that the situation between our peoples has become explosive.
Tear up your treaties and go back to your own country.
Greatest Canadian number 37 wasn't born in Canada and was never a Canadian. So why do Canadians respond to him so much?
He really detested the American government and felt that they were out to obliterate the Indians, and he wasn't too far off on that. And he felt the best hope for his people, the Shawnee, was to be affiliated with the British.
Tecumseh banded the Native nations together to fight the Americans and took our side in the War of 1812, which, by the way, thanks in part to him, we won.
He was joined by warriors that he had lined up from all these different tribes. So there are all these warriors in full war paint, like at Moravian Town or the Battle of the Thames, all because of Tecumseh's ability to bring people together.
At this moment, the Americans are plowing up the graves of my ancestors. Tomorrow, they will do the same to yours.
One of the great warriors of North American history. I was actually fascinated with him because he'd received an excellent English education, reading Shakespeare while going on the warpath.
Tecumseh gave his life in the battle to repel the Yankee hordes, and Canadians haven't forgotten.
Tecumseh helped out Canada at a critical time in its history. So even though he wasn't a Canadian, there wasn't a Canada yet, but an Upper Canada, I would think that's probably why he made it to the list.
So near to the list and yet so far, we give you some almost greats. Gordie Howe, stick handled to 53. Glenn Gould, scaled to 55. And Captain Kirk, beamed up to 56. Stay with us as the Top 50 continues.
Closed captioning is brought to you by Century 21, the local experts. To purchase or sell your home fast, call a Century 21 sales professional.
Why play your way to the Grey Cup when Subway Restaurants is giving away 5 trips to the big game? Come in, then enter online. Plus, with any Lay's potato chip purchase, you get another chance to win from Subway.
Moores has everything you need to update your wardrobe. Suits, outerwear, casual wear, and shoes, all at great low prices. Moores. Well made, well priced, well dressed.
Want maximum cleaning power? Get the new Oral-B Cross-Action Power Max. It's rechargeable and won't fade like battery toothbrushes, so it's always at peak cleaning power. Keep your smile fully charged with the new Oral-B Cross-Action Power Max.
Thank you.
Pontiac drivers don't break the law. They just get out of the way a lot better. Introducing Pontiac Wave.
Swanson Hardy Bowls make a tastier lunch at work.
What? It's 9:15.
Perhaps too tasty. Swanson Hardy Bowls. When you're starved for time.
You know, we do what we can, but it's a never-ending supply. We stop one, Japan sends three more. It's a battle we just can't win.
Player's choice. 40 premium titles, just $29.95 a hit, including Legend of Zelda, Wind Waker, rated E to teen.
These kids don't stand a chance.
As the nights grow longer, the lights go on sale at Ottawa's Living Lighting. Save on a wide selection of lights, fans, and accessories. Save on House Beautiful Lighting Solutions by Kichler, available in Ottawa only at Living Lighting. Save on exquisite Schoenbeck crystal chandeliers, Snock outdoor lighting, and artistic ceiling fans by Casablanca. Save on lights for longer nights during the fall sale. On now at all three locations. Ottawa's Living Lighting.
It's big. Everybody watches it. Everybody talks about it. It's like a water cooler type thing, you know?
The first season took the country by storm.
The action, the excitement, it kind of starts off friendly, and there's a lot of drinking, and everyone starts yelling, and it just goes from there.
This Monday, Rick Mercer's Monday Report makes its triumphant return at a new time.
Now at 9.
Are you going to watch it?
Yes.
Lots of hype leading up to it.
Sure is.
This Monday, only on CBC Television.
Next on The Greatest Canadian, you voted for someone who never won a military battle, didn't cure a disease or invent the telephone, but he could do great things with popsicle sticks.
Hi, I'm glad you came to see me today.
Oh, Mr. Dressup, I love him. Oh my gosh, I totally grew up with Mr. Dressup. Like, he warms my heart to think of him. He was just so sweet. Just, and so engaging, and just totally normal. You're just sitting there at home. I can remember just, like, hanging out with Mr. Dressup, sitting on the couch.
Strings are very good things to save and to look at because they're pretty.
Mm-hmm.
And they're very useful, too.
Because you tie up stuff with them.
We now have a grandson, and we have dress-up tapes, and Zev is completely engaged in dress-up tapes. He loves them. And I can see that what Ernie Coombs was able to do was to establish an immediate rapport because it was so unthreatening.
Here I am, ready to go aboard my boat and sail across the ocean.
His was a rare and treasured art. He certainly qualifies as great.
Here come the circus horses prancing. Here come the clowns in a row all dancing.
I had the good fortune of traveling with Mr. Dressup. And traveling with Mr. Dressup anywhere was like traveling with one of the Beatles. And his popularity spanned decades, you know, kids under 5 and women over 60. You would think he was Elvis. And I think it's interesting that Ernie Coombs is American, but Mr. Dressup is Canadian, and nobody can de-Canadianify Mr. Dressup.
Goodbye from Miss Biz the Lighthouse and Seagull Finnegan and Casey Sailor and me.
Mr. Dressup.
Number 35 on your list walked miles through a swamp to warn about an American attack. She was unafraid, so the story goes, because she had with her the most Canadian of weapons, a cow.
Tell Laura I love her. Tell Laura I need her.
Yes, everybody loves Laura Secord candy.
Laura Secord's legacy is, you know, for me personally, 3 root canals as a result of her suckers and chocolate and ice cream. And, you know, my dentist would certainly say she is a great Canadian.
Oh, it could be.
Oh, no, it's just a coincidence.
It can't be.
The trouble with being a legend like Laura Secord is we're always making fun of her and the cow.
Come along, Agnes. Come along, Beauty. That's the girl.
I'll never forget the day I overheard the Americans planning a sneak attack on the British post at Beaver Dams.
June 21st, 1813.
If I can interrupt, Laura. Are you sure it was 1813? After all, it's called the War of 1812.
The first thing I've known about Lauren Secord, there wasn't a cow. But she was a strong-minded woman. She hiked all the way across that terrain to get to the British side, or the Canadian side, and deserves some kind of an accolade.
Did she even get a thank you for her efforts? No, not at the time. She had to fight for her place in history. When she was 85, the British government finally came up with a little cash. But she did get her name on millions of boxes of chocolates.
Quite a few of you tried to vote your mums onto the greatest Canadian list. How sweet is that? And there were a few granddads nominated too. There was even a grassroots campaigner in Montreal with his own website. Sorry, Jesse, you didn't make it. But one such campaign actually worked. I guess it helps if you have your own radio show.
Power 97, news update.
Good morning, Hal Anderson.
Police. Number 34, Winnipeg morning radio host Hal Anderson. Way to go, Hal. You got the vote out.
An exercise like this is an exercise in direct democracy, and some of the choices prove that direct democracy doesn't work. This is why we don't run by referendum.
Number 33 is on the list because he writes stirring folk ballads about Canada and our history. Not the usual path to the Billboard Top 10.
There was a time in this fair land when the railroad did not run. And the wild, majestic mountains stood alone against the sun.
You know, you'd stop somebody in the street in Saskatoon, Regina, New Liskeard, and say, you know, sing me a piece of the Canadian Railroad Trilogy, or sing me any piece of a Gordon Lightfoot song, and they'll probably be able to do it.
So over the mountains and over the plains, into the muskeg and into the rain.
I remember the first time that I heard the Canadian Railway Trilogy, I got shivers up and down my back. I hadn't traveled at all in Canada, yet somehow I had the impression that through that I had got to know this country better, just through listening to his lyrics and to the rhythms that he managed to capture.
If you could read my
Gordon Lightfoot is very near the top of my list of greatest Canadians because his voice is evocative and more nostalgic for me than the smell of a pine cottage when you open it up for the first time May 2-4 weekend.
Superior, they said, never gives up for dead when the gales of November come early.
Curiously enough, one of his best-known songs is about the sinking of an American ship. Yeah. But I think it's sunk on the Canadian side of the border, so it's okay.
Baby face, you got the cutest little baby face.
Michael J. Fox has comic timing and charm, which made him huge in the 80s. First, he was a conservative battling hippie parents as Alex P. Keaton.
You got a copy of the Fortune 500 in your wallet?
No, I wish. I only have the top 25 in my wallet. I keep the complete list under my pillow.
Then he battled time itself as Marty McFly.
You've got to come back with me.
Where?
Back to the future.
Later, he was producer and star of Spin City.
This is awesome.
And still fit in over 40 movies. But he may have made number 32 on your list because of his personal battle against Parkinson's disease.
I think about how much courage it took for him to come out and talk about Parkinson's and to be willing to continue to shoot Spin City while his Parkinson's was, you know, quite visible. Because I think, you know, the media is a place where no one wants to show any sort of weakness or fault.
I can expect in my 40s to face challenges most won't expect until their 70s or 80s, if ever.
I look at him and I think, good for you, because he has brought great positive attention to the disease. And, you know, that could lead to obviously raising money and in the end maybe finding a cure.
During the next 30 minutes, you'll meet three personalities who made history on the nation's front pages. Tonight on Front Page Challenge.
In the 60s and 70s, you could barely turn on Canadian TV without seeing his big white sideburns, bow tie, and a comb-over that would make Donald Trump jealous.
People are always saying, oh, but you can't say that. Can't say that. And I think there's only one answer to people who say that, and that's to question them, to say why.
I grew up listening to him on the radio and found him to be a guy like Don Cherry, who would get in trouble, who would say stuff, who would really step out and say, I don't care whether you like it, I don't care whether I'm going to get in trouble, this is me. And for that reason, I admire Pierre Burton.
The church won't allow me to be a member because there's certain things I don't believe about the church.
You know, old Frosty Top there, I remember buying a collection of Pierre Burton's columns from the 1960s. Oh man, they're amazing. They're so trenchant. They totally kick ass.
Look at my book.
Burton's place on your list, though, is probably thanks to his popular history books. Many history books, some of which became epic TV dramas.
It's a great service that he's provided to the country. And it took courage as well. Because of that subject, because Canadians were convinced that the history was so boring, Pierre Burton came along and said, no, it's not.
So the little locomotive rattled over the newly laid rail, and over the last spike, and down the long incline of the mountains.
Well, I think it's pretentious to be on that list myself, for me. I think they're better icons than I, but I don't mind being called an icon. If people want to call me that, sure, let them call me. I won't deny it.
I'm going to wheel around the world to raise awareness and funds for spinal cord research.
We like our heroes to have a can-do attitude, and the next nominee delivered. He's the man in motion, Rick Hansen. And to get to number 30, all he had to do was wheel himself 40,000 kilometers around the entire world.
In China, he was given the kind of hero's welcome seldom shown to foreigners.
Rick, to me, says courage, strength of body, obviously, but of spirit. Strength of spirit, and that's a great attribute.
Hansen himself exemplifies his dream. Paralyzed after a truck accident when he was 15, the wheelchair athlete thought his life was over.
I want to thank you for believing in the potential of disabled persons.
I can't imagine what it must take to decide in your mind that you're going to wheel around the world or run across Canada when people around you are saying, you've got to be crazy. Doing it not for yourself, but for complete strangers. And I don't think we see enough of that today. But I think that we should uphold that as an incredibly wonderful and Canadian virtue.
Everybody has, you know, a bit of greatness in them that they can actually nurture and grow, and they can... they can do things they never thought possible if they believe in themselves, if they've got the right people beside them, and they don't give up.
Coming up next, the third of four funny men you voted on the list.
A Canadian woman found dead in a suitcase. The killer left a trail of clues. Scotland Yard had the evidence.
They know he killed my sister.
Why is the killer still free? Wednesday at 9 on CBC News, The Fifth Estate. Vote. Watch. Now own the series that celebrates the greatest Canadian. This one-time television event is available on video cassette and DVD for yourself or as a gift. Order this piece of Canadian history.
How great is this? Just me and my delicious Subway sub. No distractions, nobody bugging me. This rules.
Rush into Subway restaurants and try our tasty sweet onion chicken teriyaki sub with 5 grams of fat made on our fresh baked bread.
Nope, doesn't get any better than this. A man and his Subway sub.
It's made with tender strips of teriyaki seasoned chicken breast, a tasty sweet onion sauce, and your choice of fresh veggies.
On second thought, it would be nice to have some company. I wonder if anyone would like to sit and talk subs.
Subway, eat fresh.
Velocity meets versatility. The all-new Hemi-powered Dodge Magnum. Open it up from either end.
I used to swim like a fish. Now I swim to stay healthy. But when I've neglected my diet, I've relied on the science of Centrum daily for complete vitamin and mineral support. Centrum Select. Complete from A to zinc.
When you have a migraine, you can try and turn the world off. Or turn to Advil Liquigel. Pause for liquid fast migraine relief. And now in extra strength.
I'll pick up dinner.
I'll get ready.
The amazing Swiffer Wet Jet with scrubbing head gives your floor a thorough clean anytime you want. Its jet action sprayer blasts stubborn dirt and grime with a high-powered cleaning solution, while its triple-layer cleaning pad sucks dirt deep inside forever. Unlike a dirty mop and bucket, you're always using fresh cleaning solution. And the exclusive scrubbing head gets up ground-in grime in a snap.
Amazing. Done it again.
Stop cleaning. Use Swiffer.
Who told you I was obsessed? Did she say that? Gel Max Comfort Grip tools are perfect for me. They're specifically designed to feel good in your hand.
I can put her down anytime I want. Not now. Maybe later.
Gel Max Comfort Grip.
I live here.
New from Black & Decker.
Some people believe there's a carpentry gene, and I think I got it. Hanging things, I'm a little hit or miss on. But with the Black & Decker Bullseye, it's foolproof. I just find a stud, hang it on the wall, and it self-levels. Gives you a straight line every time.
Laser levels from Black & Decker.
Only one, okay?
Urgent call for the sample lady. Urgent phone call for the...
Once you've tasted Cavendish Farms oven crisp fries, you'll do anything to have some more.
The trail of evidence leads to a new night.
Aye, 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 aye.
Da Vinci makes his mark.
I should be looking into this a little bit deeper.
Tuesdays on CBC.
How many enemies do you want to make, Dominic? Hey?
An exciting new season.
They keep asking my opinion.
The award-winning crime-solving drama.
Might be nice to stop something before it happened for a change.
Now, on a new night.
Okay, I think I got the message.
Da Vinci's Inquest. Tuesday at 9 on CBC Television.
Here's the third of four comics who made it to the top 50.
My analyst told me that I was right out of my head the way he described it. He said I'd be better dead than alive. I didn't listen.
Okay.
I knew all along he was all wrong, and I knew that if I was crazy, but I'm not.
My will be done!
Often compared to Jerry Lewis, with his broad and sometimes juvenile comedy, Jim Carrey is often a love him or hate him proposition. A lot of you out there must love him.
I have to take a pill every 6 hours or I feel funny.
What's it called?
Advanced delusionary schizophrenia with involuntary narcissistic rage.
I've always had a great respect and admiration for the particular kind of humor that Jim Carrey projected, because it was so physical. I've got the
power! Around the world, people know who Jim Carrey is. And I think as Canadians, we often look to that sort of external validation. You know, if everyone in the world loves Jim Carrey, then Jim Carrey must be great, rather than judging it just on, what has he done for Canada? What has he done for Canada lately? That's my question. Come on,
Conan. Well, he did show up for Canadian Week.
Try the music of my native land.
All right.
When Late Night came to Toronto.
There's a place to stand and a place to roam. They call this land Ontario.
Jim Carrey made the list. Well, that means there's a difference between great Canadians and famous Canadians. I mean, he's a great actor, he's a very funny guy, but a great Canadian, what has he actually contributed to Canada? Aside from the fact that American-owned movie chains make good money off his films.
Somebody stop me!
I'm not certain that 10 years from now we're going to still be thinking of Jim Carrey as a great Canadian.
Number 28 died for our country before we had a country.
Brock was not a Canadian, and I wouldn't call him a great Canadian because he was British to the core, and he wanted to get the hell out of Canada.
Brock is the third person on the list, famous for taking on those damn Yankees in the War of 1812, which we won. We beat them. Thank you, General Brock.
The Americans tried 5 times to cross the border and take over the country, and 5 times we, or really the British, repulsed them.
And there's Brock, a giant of a man, and splendid in his general uniform, leading the charge up the hill.
No, no, no.
He was
one of those kind of guys of, there they are, let's go get them. And of course caught the bullet and died the hero's death.
Greatness can be measured in so many ways. You can be a general at Queenston Heights, or you can be the Queen of Las Vegas.
My dream is to be international star.
She sure did it. She's been number one just about everywhere.
I was in Peru one year, trekking to the Machu Picchu, and there are people there, the Quechua people, who don't speak Spanish, who don't speak English, who don't speak French. And you get there, you start talking, and you find out that they're listening to Celine Dion. And then you think, my God, this is a really big thing.
You know, I remember meeting her last year in Chicago. Her husband said to me, you know, I think of Celine as the Olympic athlete of singing. I'm everything
I
am
because you love me. I am not particularly a fan of her genre of music, which is take a song, sprinkle some NutraSweet over it, glaze it with honey, and then bake it 425. But I was working as a writer on the Juno Awards and had the luxury and privilege of sitting in the second row of Cobb's Coliseum when Celine did her sound check. And the second she opened her mouth, she just blew the roof off the place.
She's larger than life. I mean, she got carried in like an Egyptian princess at her wedding. I mean, how many times have you seen that? I think that it's just she's so huge in terms of a brand that people automatically think that that's what greatness means. And I think that greatness is something completely different. Doctor, give me the news. I got a
bad case of loving you. Norman Bethune was a Canadian doctor who, from the Spanish Civil War to Mao Zedong in China, made this tremendous contribution of providing medical services and a medical infrastructure, clinics, hospitals, etc., in another country because of his driving compassion and sense of urgency about the human condition.
Bethune was a battlefield surgeon. He invented the mobile hospital and blood bank before anyone had heard the term MASH unit.
Norman Bethune was a doctor without borders before there were doctors without borders. He's probably the first in the world.
You have done more for the sick and wounded than any other man I know. You have made yourself one of us.
The future belongs to us.
Bethune was a great man, especially as portrayed by Donald Sutherland. While Sutherland, one of our finest actors, didn't make the list, he'd surely be delighted that the good doctor did.
I think Norman Bethune did it not for money. He did it for heart. He did it because of his beliefs. He did it because of a great love for the Chinese people. And I think it was the shining moment of his life where he could be part of something bigger.
Doctor, you cannot do this with your injured hand. The risk of infection is too great.
She was right. He was toast. Once Bethune was dead, his communist views were overlooked in Canada. In China, he got statues and museums.
One of the three required books of the Cultural Revolution was a book that Mao wrote about Norman Bethune, so everybody knows about him in China because of that experience. But his life is worth knowing about. So I'm really pleased that people would nominate Bethune because he is the first Canadian international humanitarian.
Your next choice would probably be really disappointed that only six women made it to the top 50. Seems obvious that women are persons, but before number 25, Canadian women were not. For a rebel, Nellie McClung was very ladylike. She hailed from a time when feminism was associated with temperance. That's how she came to take on the male establishment of the day over women's right to vote.
No true woman wants the vote. My wife does not want the vote. Neither did my mother.
Any woman who classes herself with idiots, lunatics, and convicts probably rates herself where she belongs. They don't have the vote either.
She played a critical role in Canadian history.
To me, I think she's a great Canadian without a doubt. She did things that would might be seem gimmicky, but they were very effective. And one of the things she did was they organized the Women's Parliament. It was held sort of three nights as a performance.
Man's place is on the farm.
Without Nellie McClung, we, you know, people of my sex would not be considered persons under the law, which is absolutely almost inconceivable for someone my age to think about, but, you know, definitely a great suffragette.
I wish she'd gone one step further, but it was impossible for her era that women would want to elect women, but they didn't. As soon as they got the vote, they elected men.
We are living dangerous times.
At 6'4" and shaped like a large pear, Arthur Currie always stuck out among the officers on the Western Front. He also stood out among all the British brass as the first ever Canadian given command of the soldiers of the Canadian Corps.
I think he's our greatest general. You see, when the Canadians first arrived in Europe, the British were going to split them into different units, Canadian here and British here. So the Canadian government said, no. We want our men together because there are certain things they know, all of them, that the other people don't know. There's a kind of a bond between them. They were a band of brothers.
Currie is a man who sees that. These are Canadian troops, Imperial forces, yes, but Canadian troops. Canadians will command them, and Canadians will make the final decisions as to how they're used.
Canadians sometimes forget that we have a significant military history, and it is one that we should be proud of. And Arthur Currie was a big part of that as a field commander at Vimy Ridge. And I'm glad that he's on that list.
Yeah, great Canadian. If anybody was tested in our youth as a nation, and came out with flying colors to articulate us as a nation, was certainly him.
Rocketing in at number 23, number 9. The second hockey player on your list, he was hockey's greatest scoring machine, Mr. 50 goals in 50 games. The only hockey player ever to have caused a riot after being suspended from the playoffs. Phew, thank goodness he made the list.
Maurice Richard was like a hero when I was a kid. So the first thing I noticed about Maurice Richard was what every player who ever went into a corner with him or ran into him on the ice noticed, which is he has these coal black eyes that are just, they're bottomless. And they're almost satanic, except he's such a sweet, gentle, and humble man that it belies the ice. But I think when he was on the ice, it was rather different.
C'est Maurice Richard qui est si populaire, c'est Maurice Richard qui score tout le temps.
C'est Maurice Richard qui est si populaire, c'est Maurice Richard.
He loved hockey so much that he couldn't play the game at anything less than 100%. Every moment on the ice was personal for him.
I wanted to win every game. I didn't want to lose. I used to hate the losing.
Number 9, Maurice Richard, breaks in savagely, breaks his stick, and knocks the puck into the net with his hand.
The determination of this person was unbelievable. Between the blue line and the goal, it's better not to be in his way. He will carry three hockey players on his back to go and put the puck in the net. And he was the most determined person I ever met in my life.
By dawn, hundreds of people circled the Molson Center, each one there to say goodbye.
I understand why when he died, there were so many tens of thousands, that including myself, who went to the Bell Center. And because even if we had not seen him, there's something very heroic and simple at the same time.
Hey, Richard, 2 minutes for looking so good. What do you say,
kinsman, kinsman, kinsman? Hey! Fellow kinsmen, we're honored this evening with the presence of our founder, beloved Hal Rogers.
If you think number 22, Harold Rogers, is the greatest Canadian, I'll bet you're a member of the Kin Club. And if you're not a Kinet or kinsman, you likely have never heard of him. step aside Shriners, Rotarians, and Kiwanis, Hal Rogers founded the Kinsmen, a Canadian service and social club that raises money for good causes. As organizations go, Rogers' place so high on the list is a testament to just how organized the kin really are. Coming up next, a great Canadian who doesn't have a name.
For many, Tuesday will be a wake-up call. For some, the end of the dream.
He's got to watch his passivity.
Passivity? Is that like he's a fraidy cat?
I want to be out there so bad.
You're cut.
Making the Cut, presented by Bell, Tuesday on CBC.
You've been waiting to do this for years. Don't let arthritis pain be your reason for not starting a little something, not making your move, not getting physical, not putting it together, not spicing things up, not loving the moment, not going for it all the way. Grab some Tylenol arthritis pain with one layer for fast relief and a second layer that delivers relief for up to 8 hours. It's the Tylenol for arthritis pain.
Our cover girl in Paradise said moisturizing lipsticks do feel nice, but do they last? Not so fast. Discover new Smooth Wear, the luscious lasting new lip color from CoverGirl. A rich color coat for sensuous color. Sealed with a conditioning top coat. Seal in the moisture, seal in the feel. It's 8-hour color you don't have to reapply. You're luscious, no matter who drops by. Moisture-rich new Smooth Wear from Easy Breezy, beautiful CoverGirl.
Any driver can recognize their own car. But how many cars can recognize their driver? Smart Access Technology. Available from Lexus.
Daddy, where's Uncle Joe?
Late as always.
Is Uncle Joe your brother?
Biologically, yeah. I think I see something. No.
Excuse me, has anyone seen my magic carpet?
Uncle Joe!
Well, if it isn't Jasmine and Jasmine.
Those my pants?
Yeah.
They look nice.
This year, plan a gathering with the characters in your family. To get started, visit disneyworld.ca.
Okay, audition in 2 weeks. Whiten your smile. No red wine, blueberry pie, coffee, tea.
Got it.
Imagine a dental plan that makes you look incredibly polished. New Crest Vivid White Toothpaste. It can give you a noticeably whiter smile in just 14 days because it helps polish away stains and helps prevent stains from returning.
Good advice.
Crest Vivid White, part of the Crest Dental Plan. Healthy looking, beautiful smiles for life.
Introducing the Acura RL. With voice-activated technology, 300 horsepower, and the world's most advanced all-wheel drive, it shifts power to exactly where you need it for magnetic-like handling. The road will never be the same. The all-new Acura RL.
A Canadian woman found dead in a suitcase. The killer left a trail of clues. Scotland Yard had the evidence.
They know he killed my sister.
Why is the killer still free? Wednesday at 9 on CBC News, The Fifth Estate.
There are three generals in your top 50 and a top gun. Number 21 is a famous soldier, too.
Call angels, call angels. Walk me through this storm. Don't leave me alone.
The ceremonial welcome home for the unknown soldier was a hugely symbolic event. It honored every Canadian soldier then and now. Your vote, too, seems to be a vote of respect for the ordinary guy in uniform.
Oh, my, the unknown soldier. What a great move. What a fabulous move to put, if I may use it, life to that great memorial in Ottawa. The unknown soldier is by far our greatest hero.
I was at the ceremony, and I felt when they interred the unknown soldier that Canadians were respecting one person who could represent the many. We don't necessarily like to single out one person as this was our greatest military hero or this was our greatest political hero. And so the unknown soldier represents the greatness of that sacrifice that was made in not just the First World War, but the Second World War and the other wars we've fought in.
We're trying, we're hoping, we're loving, and we're hurting. We're crying, we're calling, those who are not sure
on the list, with so many takes on greatness, we go from the unknown to the hard to miss. Yeah, baby. Number 20, Mike Myers.
Thank you very much for your kind applause on my entrance. I always like a warm hand on my opening.
In a fickle comedy world where an actor is lucky to create one memorable character, Myers has nailed a half dozen, including two that have spawned huge motion picture franchises.
Yeah, baby, yeah!
For sure he's higher than Jim Carrey on the list, because he wears his Canuckness like a badge.
You know what's funny? Mike is probably more Canadian now since he left Canada than he ever was when he was working at the Second City here in Toronto. He is Mr. Canada, Captain Canada.
Okay, I still live with my parents, which I admit is both bogus and sad.
What impressed me the most about him is that years later, when he became super famous, I was sitting in a little restaurant in New York, and I looked across the way, and there was Mike Myers sitting there with his wife. It was like, you know, but, and my friend said, oh, it's Mike Myers, why don't you go over and say hi to him? And I thought, oh, no, I can't. He's, like, way too famous. And before I knew it, he came over to my table, and he said, I just wanted to say hi. It's so great to see you. You know, I grew up watching you on the new music, and I just felt like, ah, incredible. You know, he was just like this regular guy.
This is definitely the type of place I'm going to get when I move out of my parents' house.
Anyone who's going to have a career of that magnitude and still, you know, be a proud patriot, I'm all for. I think he's great.
This is me in a nutshell. Help! I'm in a nutshell!
He made it to number 19, the pride of Parry Sound, Ontario.
Hello out there. We're on the air. It's hockey night tonight.
It was an interesting way of defending he had. He scored instead. The first defenseman ever to win the scoring championship.
Someone roars, Bobby scores at the good old hockey game.
He looked like a kid. Even when he was 30 years old and beaten up and his knees had broken down, he still looked like a young kid who embodied what all of us want to be, which is young and full of life and talented.
Bobby Orr, behind the net to Sanderson, to Orr! Bobby Orr! Scores in the Boston Bruins! Has won the Stanley Cup!
When I was a kid, 15 years old, you know, just thinking about sport, you know, there was only one athlete that stood up in my world, and that was Bobby Orr. And you know, he was the greatest athlete in the world. I used to skip out of school to watch him play. Oops.
Forever associated with the Boston Bruins, Canadians also remember him as the MVP of the 1976 Canada Cup winning Team Canada, which likely helped him, wonky knees and all, onto our list.
Bobby Orr was probably the greatest defenseman of all times. To watch some of the films, it's unfortunate that he didn't play that long in the NHL, only played 10 years, but when he was there, he was an incredible player.
Let's go, girls. The highest-ranking woman on the Great Canadian List. At number 18, you chose the most famous midriff in Canadian history. She's the best-selling female country artist of all time.
Oh, I love Shania's music. I mean, everybody does. I mean, I drive around in my van. We listen to the music. We sing. You know, we sing along.
Who's been? Have your boots been under?
My daughter went to the Shania concert, third row. She was just like, she couldn't believe it. In Saskatoon, they had to have a second concert because she sold out in 3 minutes. And she came from a very hard scrabble background, you know, an Indian father in the First Nations community. We adopted Shania, we love Shania. and she's a superstar.
I had to help my family. I had to, you know, I was driven not by ambition, but by desperation. I needed to make it.
This is what a woman wants.
I'll take it.
I recognize, you know, the groundbreaking nature of Shania Twain's music in that she was one of the, you know, huge crossovers from country to pop and sort of created a bridge there for other artists. I think that having a really flat stomach is probably very difficult to achieve and maintain, but I don't know that it makes you a great Canadian. That don't impress me
much. I think she's darn pretty, and she sings good, and she's gutsy. It was great to see her come back and host the Junos in a hockey sweater.
Hello, Canada!
It's like, aren't you supposed to do something really heroic to get this title? But then, you know, music does touch a lot of lives. It means a lot to people. It's a very personal thing. And, I mean, music can change people's lives. So I understand that. You know, it's not so much me. I think I'm just a hosiery.
Number 18 has the whole world listening to her. Number 17 is fighting hard to get his message heard. When out on the street today, the Canadian dream was as far away as it's ever been, as it's ever been. S-O-C-I-A-L-I-S-M, it's here to stay. He's one of two capital S socialists on the list, a former leader of the NDP in Ontario. But many of you voted for him for being a voice for Africa. In his role as UN Special Envoy for HIV/AIDS in Africa, he's the David to the drug company's Goliath.
When it's all over, AIDS will have taken more lives than all of the lives lost, military and civilian, in the First and Second World Wars.
For me, Stephen Lewis has brought an enormous amount of attention to the AIDS epidemic in Africa, and I think that's something that we all need to think about. So he's got people thinking.
I see this kind of thing, and I know that it just doesn't have to be.
Yeah.
It never had, these kids never had to be infected.
It has been emotionally very difficult because I wasn't prepared for the death, and particularly death of young women in their 20s. It's just ghastly and appalling. And because it's unnecessary, it sort of strangles the soul.
The drug should be available free to everyone, particularly the poorest people.
All over East and Southern Africa, you have child-headed households.
I feel angry because it's all so nuts.
Stephen Lewis is a tireless pain in the neck and has been all his life. To the forces of evil throughout the world.
Treatment is the current agenda. It will remain the current agenda.
I don't think he sometimes made himself the most popular guy that there could ever be because he's really stuck to his lefty principles.
Would you tell the mother that I'm really very, very pleased to have met her and I'm very happy she's in treatment?
I qualify because of an accident of timing. As a Canadian who is working with the United Nations on the probably greatest scourge in human history, there is a natural recognition. But does it qualify for greatness? No, it doesn't.
Africa sets the stage for your next great Canadian, too. Here's a general who didn't win a battle. He tried and failed to stop a genocide. That failure, though, puts him higher on your list than any other military hero.
He is a hero. I think he's done as much good as any person could coming out of the horrors of Rwanda. He's testified at the trials. He goes around this country and other countries speaking about it. You can't measure the impact of all that, but I have an instinctive sense that it's important.
We're not talking about a murder
or a traffic accident. We're talking about a country that went up in smoke.
He's one of those people who's made me very proud to be a Canadian in the way he reacted to the tragedy in Rwanda. Not just as a military man, not with a political sense, but as a human being. I think Roméo Dallaire has reminded us in a very profound way what it really means to be a human being. Not just a Canadian, but a human being.
This nation has a responsibility in the world to advance the plight of the 80% that's still in the mud and the blood and the suffering.
It was instinctive. It was instinctive as much as being Canadian and seeing suffering and killing and abuse. And so it's unwarranted. It's just us. That's how we are. And that's how I reacted.
We're getting close to that top 10. I'll be back with number 15.
It's big. Everybody watches it. Everybody talks about it. It's like a water cooler type thing, you know?
The first season took the country by storm.
The action, the excitement, it kind of starts off friendly, and there's a lot of drinking, and everyone starts yelling, and it just goes from there.
This Monday, Rick Mercer's Monday Report makes its triumphant return at a new time.
Now at 9.
Are you going to watch it?
Yes.
Lots of hype leading up to it.
Sure is.
This Monday, only on CBC Television.
Why play your way to the Grey Cup when Subway Restaurants is giving away 5 trips to the big game? Come in, then enter online. Plus, with any Lay's potato chip purchase, you get another chance to win from Subway.
Canada's lawyers are making a difference through their work.
There's a lot of responsibility involved in representing other people's interests.
It's important to listen carefully and offer the best advice to my clients.
And through involvement in the community.
It's important to help young people understand our legal system. I get a lot of personal satisfaction learning about people and the issues that affect them.
Discover the many ways Canada's lawyers are serving their clients and their communities.
Don't forget.
Gouda. 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 Gouda.
Havarti?
A legendary actress.
Everything's so tedious. I want something to happen.
A handsome admirer.
Remember that young chap I introduced you to? Young American. Good looking fellow.
Bagley.
An ambitious starlet.
I'm putting you under contract.
With platinum and peroxide, there's no lack of blondes these days.
Hers is natural.
I wonder how you know that.
Annette Bening, Jeremy Irons, being Julia.
In select cities, October 22nd. Everywhere, October 29th.
I'll pick up dinner.
I'll get ready.
The amazing Swiffer Wet Jet with scrubbing head gives your floor a thorough clean anytime you want. Its jet action sprayer blasts stubborn dirt and grime with a high-powered cleaning solution, while its triple-layer cleaning pad sucks dirt deep inside forever. Unlike a dirty mop and bucket, you're always using fresh cleaning solution. And the exclusive scrubbing head gets up ground in grime in a snap.
Amazing. Done it again.
Stop cleaning. Use Swiffer.
They feel just like underwear, and I don't have to worry about waking up with wet sheets.
New Goodnight's disposable underpants have been redesigned to help protect better than ever. Boys where they need it most, girls where they need it most.
I feel so much more relieved. I won't wet my bed anymore.
Mama, I gotta go potty now!
Accidents happen, and because we know training, only Pull-Ups training pants have easy open sides, just in case.
You made it! I'm a big kid now.
My mind just won't shut down.
It's been diagnosed as a muscle strain.
Internal lacerations, bruising. Go, 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 go! I don't care if I'm hurt, whatever it takes.
For many, Tuesday will be a wake-up call. For some, the end of the dream.
I want to be out there so bad.
I'm definitely here to be the top 6.
We want to be really aggressive.
Back in.
He's got major league speed.
Come on!
The falling players are on the bubble.
I gotta figure out a way to outdo everybody else.
Your cut.
Making the Cut, presented by Bell. Tuesday on CBC. Brought to you in part by Samsung.
Number 15 was heard by millions of Canadians interviewing prime ministers, authors, movie stars, scientists, and athletes. And all the while, you thought he was just talking to you.
Sometime this year, Wayne Gretzky will get his 1,000th goal as a hockey player. Wayne turned 13 when? January?
Yes.
How many goals have you scored this year?
178.
I would be sitting between practices in Victoria listening to him interview a bricklayer in, you know, northern Saskatchewan and really find it interesting. I want to know more about life in northern Saskatchewan or the plight of farmers in Alberta. He had a way of making every little town, every little place in Canada seem, he brought out the specialness in those places and those people.
Good morning, I'm Peter Zosky. This is Morningside.
But what he did on radio was essentially what the railroad did, joined the country together. But he did it in the modern way, and he did it in a chatty way.
Prime Minister, good morning.
Good morning.
Talk to me about your conviction. Talk
they
to me
do.
From, speak from the heart, Jean.
Yes, they matter to me.
Peter would be on my Mount Rushmore. He was a tireless guy for a lot of reasons, not the least being his campaign to get everybody in Canada to be able to read.
Every one of those books around here has got somebody new you can meet and some place new you can go.
He was laid back. He was inquisitive. He had done his preparation, and he understood the country.
See you soon, I hope. I'm Peter Zosky. Good
morning. Zosky spent much of his life promoting Canadian authors, which, if our list is any indication, is a job that remains unfinished. Neil Young is still the god of garage bands everywhere. He's never retired to the golden oldie list. He keeps reinventing himself.
Neil Young was our icon, you know, in the late 60s and early 70s and all the great music that he did. He just seemed like this great, groovy, cool, humble guy that was, you know, ultimately Canadian. His music was the kind of stuff that you would listen to, you know, in your basement on, you know, with the headsets on as you were, like, smoking dope. I've been a miner
for a heart of gold. If you did a great greatest musician of all time in any country, Neil would be like top 5, top 10. And his guitar playing, not a trained guitar player, not a studied guitar player, but considered one of the most emotional guitar players of all time. Classic solos that will go down in history.
I like his lyrics, I like his melodies, I just think just everything about, I just think he's a great songwriter. He's stayed pretty cool and pretty credible his entire career, and I think that's something very respectable. Somehow our innocence is
lost. I remember in the video of the recording of Tears Are Not Enough, you know, did his line in the song. And the sound engineer said, I think you were a little flat when you performed that line.
That's my sound, man.
And I thought, good for him. Really summed up what he was. You know, obviously not the greatest voice ever, but unique. In a world of homogenized music where the key is squeeze everything together so you fall in that range, Neil Young's way out here. And to me, that's what made him a great Canadian.
Ain't singing for Pepsi. Ain't singing for Coke.
I think he's very cool. I think he's cool because he isn't defined by any one time. You know, his contribution can be seen sort of over the course of decades. And he's one of those people who will continue to create and be creative until they die.
I have this one feeling tonight. I'm proud to be a Canadian. Thank you very much.
Just take a little piece of PEI and old Saskatchewan.
The only name on the list that comes with a folksy adjective, number 13, is Stompin' Tom Connors.
Alberta and Manitoba, Ontario and BC, and you'll have found the stomping grounds of all my friends and me.
Over 50 years, he's not only played every Canadian town with a stoplight and a watering hole, but he's brought the small town to the big city and captured it all in song.
I'm a BTC skedaddler.
At a time when most music aped, you know, American or British sounds, he was the first guy to stand up and write and sing about Canada. And we look back 30 years down the line, we realize how important and vital that is to contemporary musical culture. He's the man, he's the one, he's it.
It's Bud the Spud from the bright red mud, rolling down a highway smiling. The Spuds are big on the back of Bud's rig. They're from Prince Edward Island. They're from Prince Edward Island.
I'm from Prince Edward Island, and I'm not going to say Stompin' Tom is the Lord where I grew up, but he's a close second.
And the girls have left the bingo, and the vines are getting stinkle. We think no more of the bingle on a Sudbury Saturday night.
I know I actually met him in a theater in Northern Ontario, and we were producing a series of shows. And in one part of the show, American flags came down from the Fly Gallery for this one song. And Stompin' Tom Connors was performing a show there, and I get a call from the theater manager saying, Mr. Connors doesn't want to perform with his American flags over his head. And I went, okay, I understand that. And they said, well, what do we do? And I said, it's Stompin' Tom Connors, take down the flags. You know, he's like an uber-Canadian.
It's Canada Day, up Canada Way on the first day of July.
Well, he's hokey, and I truly think there's a part of us that doesn't mind being hokey. And he's extremely hokey. We wouldn't want to be that hokey. But we like him to be that hokey, because then we can point to him and say he's our hokiness. And he can have it.
We raise our hands and hail our flag, the maple leaf forever.
At number 12, a unique great Canadian. The only nominee on your list who's been compared to Mother Teresa.
I will give you everything that you've ever wanted.
If goodness is your idea of greatness, then Jean Vanier is your man. The son of the first French-Canadian Governor General of Canada, he chose to devote his life to caring for the most neglected and shunned in society, mentally disabled adults.
They had lived being not important for anyone. They'd been put into institutions, a disappointment for their parents and so on.
Thank you. Hallelujah.
But what touched me was everyone, either verbally or just through the body, asked a fundamental question, which, do you love me? Am I important for you? So that touched me.
He called his first home for them, L'Arche, and it's now the center of a worldwide network of 120 communities.
He could have done anything. He was given the opportunity around him to become whatever he wanted to become, and he chose to be a real person of true love for humanity. That, to me, is absolutely great.
I'm not surprised at all that Jean Vanier would make it really high on that list. I think as Canadians we think that we're very compassionate. So Jean Vanier is probably the best example of that.
People are important. And I think for some people, or a number of people, I'm a sign of hope. Because I think at the heart of L'Arche is the message of hope that every person is important.
The typical name on this list is a white man and Canadian patriot. Our next entry, who came within a whisker of making the top 10, shakes up the stereotype of the greatest Canadian list, as he's not white, and you wouldn't exactly call him a Canadian patriot. After all, he's the only guy on the list tried, convicted, and hung for treason.
This time I have a plan for me, for our people, for all the oppressed people of the world.
God will protect us!
He led the Métis in the Northwest Rebellion and was eventually defeated by the Canadian Army at the Battle of Batoche.
In the name of God, keep firing!
Any Canadian who has a drop of Métis or Indigenous blood, you know, can relate to Riel, because Riel stood his ground that Aboriginal people had to be recognized and respected within this country.
I have seen
an entire way of life trampled by a new civilization they did not understand. And for a brief moment, I stood in the path of this civilization.
It is the sentence of this court that you be taken from here to the police guardroom in Regina and there be hanged by the neck until you are dead.
He was hanged in spite of the jury's recommendation for mercy and pleas of Quebecers to spare him.
Courage, Stephen.
Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Louis Riel is at the same time Canada's favorite hero and Canada's favorite villain. And I think obviously if he made it that high on the list, then the attitude about him is changing and people are looking at the impact he had in Canada politically and culturally as a more positive thing than perhaps we did 10, 15, 20 years ago.
Give us this day our daily bread and forgive us our trespasses.
After his execution, he didn't rise from the dead, as some thought he would, but Métis leader Louis Riel's place on our list shows a resurrection of sorts as a kind of northern Che Guevara.
My name is Louis Riel. I'm the head of the provisional state.
Today, he's the star of an opera.
Ladies and gentlemen of the jury.
Got a retrial on TV, and has gone pop culture as a comic book hero.
Courage, mon père.
He's like the Nelson Mandela of the Métis. I mean, that's how big he was. And he paid for it with his life. You don't get bigger than that. How powerful can an idea be that your own government engineers to kill you for it? So, I think he belongs there.
Raise a little hell, raise a little hell.
After this break, we'll be back with the moment you've all been waiting for, the top 10 picks for the greatest Canadian.
Sir, there have been incidents.
Inspired by real events.
You're gonna look after him, right?
If you make us think about this, you will kill the unit.
Suction! I can't see what I'm doing!
You are not qualified to evaluate his competence.
I know what's going on in there.
One woman risks all.
You're crossing a line.
So she can live with her conscience.
So many children have died.
You take this matter into your hands and you're gambling with your license.
Megan follows in the new gripping drama, Open Heart, Sunday, October 24th on CBC Television.
How great is this? Just me and my delicious Subway sub. No distractions, nobody bugging me. This rules.
Rush into Subway restaurants and try our tasty sweet onion chicken teriyaki sub with 5 grams of fat made on our fresh baked bread.
Nope, doesn't get any better than this. A man and his Subway sub.
It's made with tender strips of teriyaki seasoned chicken breast, a tasty sweet onion sauce, and your choice of fresh veggies.
On second thought, it would be nice to have some company. I wonder if anyone would like to sit and talk subs.
Subway, eat fresh.
We see the old ways and the new ways in balance, expanding, flourishing, going global. We see a business full of potential. We're inspired to create software that helps them reach it.
Okay, audition in 2 weeks. Whiten your smile. No red wine, blueberry pie, coffee, tea.
Got it.
Imagine a dental plan that makes you look incredibly polished. New Crest Vivid White Toothpaste. It can give you a noticeably whiter smile in just 14 days because it helps polish away stains and helps prevent stains from returning.
Good advice.
Crest Vivid White, part of the Crest Dental Plan. Healthy looking, beautiful smiles for life.
The nation's biggest comedy tour is crashing back into town. It's the Lipton Just for Laughs comedy tour presented in association with Canada Post.
Someday this can all be yours.
Join Jeremy Hotz, Russell Peters, and many more for the event critics say is as good as stand-up gets. We'll see you live in Kingston, Montreal, Hamilton, Toronto, Ottawa, and Thunder Bay. For details, visit hahaha.com.
Wow.
The Lipton Just for Laughs comedy tour presented in association with Canada Post. Breaking loose across Canada.
Few relationships in life are more important than the one between you and your Michelin tires.
Rugged, long-lasting Michelin light truck tires. Michelin, because so much is riding on your tires.
We're doing pretty good. We're both working.
Yep. But in a few years, we want out of the city.
We don't want to keep this pace going forever. We want to travel. We want to relax.
We need some kind of plan to make it happen.
And that's why we called you. You guys can help, right?
Yeah, sure we can.
At TD Waterhouse, we listen so you get the right plan. TD Waterhouse.
This is it, the top 10 finalists. The names on this list reveal a lot about Canada and Canadian values. I'm going to announce them now in alphabetical order. From this top 10, you can choose and vote for your greatest Canadian in the coming weeks. You'll see a show about each candidate presented by 10 of Canada's best-known personalities who will argue passionately for your vote. It'll be a no-holds-barred campaign. We begin with the first of two Nobel Prize winners who made the top 10.
'Cause what you need is good, good medicine.
A Nobel Prize winner for science, he was plain speaking and unassuming, a farm boy who toiled in a dingy University of Toronto lab. His claim to fame? The discovery of the treatment for diabetes.
Oh, God. Oh, don't do that.
Battling for the good doctor is not a scientist, but actor and comic Mary Walsh. The Princess Warrior is going to bend your ear, with the help of some friends, on behalf of Sir Frederick.
Okay, so the name of the game is the greatest Canadian. Well, there can only be one winner, Frederick Banting. Yes, he had the most important discovery in modern medical history, insulin. It saved the lives of millions of people around the world. And then Banting went ahead and insisted that no one could make a personal profit from that discovery. I don't think greatest is going far enough. How about most noble Canadian, most selfless Canadian, most heroic and most honorable?
Your next choice was the most famous man in the world to call Brantford, Ontario, his home. And no, it's not Wayne Gretzky. He gave us the phone, one of the all-time great inventors claimed by three countries. Remember, though, he made that first long-distance call in Canada.
Inventing the telephone is one thing. Proving to the public it works, that's something else entirely.
Evan Solomon, writer and host of CBC News Sunday, is intrigued by how technology changes our lives. His guy, Bell, had 18 patents in his name.
Oh, Bell loved flying these things.
Evan goes back to Brantford, Ontario, where as a young man, Bell hung around the Grand River and later made that call.
Who else but the greatest Canadian would be inspired by the natural beauty of Canada and hurtle us into the modern age? Alexander Graham Bell was a genius, a visionary, a humanitarian, and he's so much more than the phone. His inventions are everywhere. And did he want money? He just wanted to make the world a better place.
Our next top 10 finalist is a choice that will thrill some of you. Up next is the guy that pioneered the monster caller. Want to scoff at Don Cherry as a great Canadian? You'll have to go through this guy, flag-waving showman, champion wrestler, Bret Hart.
I'm Bret the Hitman Hart, and I'm here to tell you that Don Cherry is the greatest Canadian. He's good.
You say thanks, Mom.
He's bad.
Politically correct. Suck.
He has a heart the size of Montreal.
Let the best team win. Why keep score?
He's the unfiltered, uncensored, raw voice of Canadians. He's the heart and soul of this country. He's the best there is, the best there was, and the best there ever will be.
From one voice of the people to another people's champion, he was the first elected socialist premier in North America. But this Canadian hero is better known as the father of Medicare.
Don't say no to me.
Before Tommy Douglas came along, even the most basic medical care was something you paid for. As Premier of Saskatchewan, Tommy Douglas was a rebel with a cause.
I think that medical care is so important that it ought not to have a price tag on it.
He promised the first universal public health care in Canada and delivered it despite the bitter opposition of the doctors.
It's not about the size of the man in the fight. It's about the size of the fight in the man.
Tommy's the man for rock journalist George Strombolopoulos. The star of Much's new music and the punk show knows a lot about attitude and rebels.
Go to hell!
He's going to pull out all the stops to convince you that Tommy Douglas is the greatest Canadian.
Tommy's values are now Canada's values. He showed us what we could be. But more importantly, he showed us how to get there. There's just no way this country would be what it is today without him.
Don't say no to the incredible medicine show. Say no. Don't say no.
Tommy Douglas was a man with a cause. Your next choice is also identified with a cause.
And those are the dreams, Eddie. A dreamer dreams.
He's the youngest hero in your top 10. He took on a heroic battle against one of our most feared enemies, cancer.
I said to people before that I'm going to do my very best to make it. I'm not going to give up, and that's true. But I might not make it. And if I don't make it, the marathon of hope better continue.
And it did. Although Terry Fox died at the age of 22, his legacy is more powerful and more global than he could ever have imagined. Hitting the road to show you that legacy and win your votes for Fox is Vancouver's Soo Kyun Lee, musician, actor, and host of CBC Radio's DNTO.
All the way to India. Terry didn't live long enough to travel to faraway places, but he's here now in Bangalore and everywhere else in the world where there's been a Terry Fox run. 50 countries, including places like China, Zimbabwe, Oman. He's one of the few great Canadians whose legacy reaches far beyond our borders.
We're halfway through the top 10. Find out the last five when we come back.
Closed captioning is brought to you by Century 21, the local experts. To purchase or sell your home fast, call a Century 21 sales professional.
When you need a sealant that's got to stick,
Mono Ultra does the trick.
Mono
Ultra.
When it calls for the best, the choice is clear.
There won't be anything like it for years.
Mono
Ultra.
It works in the sun.
It works in your shower.
You wash up with water
and hang it in hours.
Exterior ceiling's a whole new drill with Mono Ultra. It cures fast, it won't shrink or crack, and it's completely paintable. Mono
Ultra. Get the Mono.
Swanson Hardy Bowls make a tastier lunch at work.
What? It's 9:15.
Perhaps too tasty. Swanson Hardy Bowls. When you're starved for time.
No two mouths are the same. New Oral-B Sonic Complete lets you customize brushing with three modes that clean, go easy on sensitive spots, massage gums. It's your mouth. Brush it your way. It feels amazing. New Oral-B Sonic Complete.
An RBC Avion card is the travel rewards card that actually makes it easy for you and your family to fly. Yes, and we're offering 10,000 bonus points upon enrollment, plus double points until August 31st, 2005. As far out of town as you'd like. RBC Royal Bank. First, for you.
I'll pick up dinner.
I'll get ready.
The amazing Swiffer Wet Jet with scrubbing head gives your floor a thorough clean anytime you want. Its jet action sprayer blasts stubborn dirt and grime with a high-powered cleaning solution, while its triple-layer cleaning pad sucks dirt deep inside forever. Unlike a dirty mop and bucket, you're always using fresh cleaning solution. And the exclusive scrubbing head gets up ground in grime in a snap.
Amazing. Done it again.
Stop cleaning. Use Swiffer.
Sunday, October 24th, climb aboard the Art Bus. 11 art galleries in one day. Free shuttle buses leaving every 15 minutes from the Ottawa School of Art. The Art Bus Experience, a one-day celebration of art. Sunday, October 24th, 10 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. on Ottawa School of Art Project.
Hey, Leo. What's going on? This isn't just a new car.
What is it then?
An opportunity for a fresh start.
Yeah, that's where that was. Just a phase. Thanks, man. And Leo, enjoy the new car.
Toyota's 05 drive, on now.
The trail of evidence leads to a new night.
Ay, 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 ay.
Da Vinci makes his mark.
I should be looking into this a little bit deeper.
An exciting new season. Da Vinci's Inquest, Tuesday at 9 on CBC.
When major events happen,
putting together a cabinet is a question of skill and regional balance.
Canadians turn to CBC News.
There's a harrowing story.
The source Canadians trust. CBC News, The National, weeknights at 10.
I'm certain it's no surprise that Terry Fox is in the top 10. As for your next choice, okay, Walter, he made it.
Walter Gretzky had a son, he grew up to be the great one. He came from Brantford, Ontario. He liked Gordie, how you know.
He's the great one, and right at home in our top 10. He rewrote the hockey record book, causing a generation of Canadian dads to build backyard rinks.
And in those days, this was Camelot for the pure hearts and the brave citizens of the West.
The Reform Party's first MP, Deborah Gray from Edmonton, is into bikes and, wouldn't you know it, the Oilers. In the face-off for the top 10, she's the enforcer for, guess who?
It's number 99. A man of grace, supernatural skill, drive, intelligence, unbelievable modesty, staggering accomplishment. A Canadian, the greatest Canadian.
Great one to the first one, Canada's very first Prime Minister.
To dream the impossible dream.
Sir John A. created Canada and pulled it off thanks to backroom brokering, compromise dealing, and cases of champagne he supplied for the negotiations. Then he kept it all together with his pet project. A choo-choo that went coast to coast.
Oh, what a magnificent beast!
Best-selling author and popular historian Charlotte Gray likes to make history come alive, and she's going to be pulling out all the stops for Sir John A.
The railway was the internet of the 19th century. Just as the internet has shrunk our world today, the Canadian Pacific Railway shrank this country. It gave the new Dominion of Canada a steel spine which held it together. One man understood how to make this happen. Sir John A. Macdonald.
The next guy on your list, another Prime Minister whose pitch for world peace won him the Nobel Peace Prize. At Expo 67, he led a country that was coming of age.
We have discovered that we do have a character and a quality of our own. Rich and diverse, but Canadian.
Back during the Suez Crisis, he came up with the idea of UN peacekeepers and gave Canada a new identity on the world stage as honest broker and peacemaker. Popular actor, director, and writer Paul Gross, as a former TV Mountie, knows a bit about keeping the peace. He risked going up in a World War I fighter to relive the wartime experiences that made Pearson a peacenik.
You know, all of the things that we think of as being uniquely Canadian, our tolerance, our diversity, our peacekeeping, our flag, these are all the result of one man. He is the greatest statesman our country has ever produced. He is our best prime minister by far. He is a guy who actually saved the world, and he won the Nobel Peace Prize. He is the greatest Canadian, and his name is Lester B. Pearson.
Your last choice wanted to save the world from war. Your next choice wants to save the planet.
Earth Angel, Earth Angel, will you be mine?
Test tube babies could very well happen within our lifetimes.
The Amazon forest is being burned to the ground. This is destruction on a gigantic scale.
This is wrong. You do not treat Mother Earth this way.
He's a professorial hero who made TV his classroom and brings science to his environmentalism.
So what made David Suzuki the man he is?
His message struck the right note with Montreal-born musician Melissa Auftermaier. She toured the world as bass guitarist with Courtney Love and then the Smashing Pumpkins. She's convinced the planet's in trouble, so she put down the bass to make the case for Suzuki.
The greatest Canadian is someone who cares about our home and native land. Someone we can count on to take action to protect it, here and now. Beautiful places like this need David Suzuki. He's devoted his life to creating an awareness of the nature of things. The air, the water, the earth, our land, our Canada.
So to the last candidate in your top 10. It's been said he was what we all wish we could be. Attractive, smart, bilingual, athletic, stylish, and rich. With his passion for multiculturalism, the Constitution, and the Charter, you could say it's Pierre Trudeau's country, and we're just living in it.
There's no place for the state in the bedrooms of a nation.
Our next caller is Harry Cole from Montreal. Welcome to the program.
Rex Murphy is a writer, host of CBC's Cross Country Checkup, and a man with opinions as big as the words he uses. His opinion of Pierre Trudeau? He's the greatest Canadian, of course.
He was a man of many guises. In calm, the reflective visionary. In crisis, an ardent champion. At times, the playful charmer. But always and essentially, the voice of who we are and what Canada can be. The greatest Canadian, he would have declined the question. We're living the answer.
So there you have it, Canada. A fascinating and controversial list. Where's it going to go from here? That's up to you. Stand by for the rules for the great race for the greatest Canadian.
It's big. Everybody watches it. Everybody talks about it. It's like a water cooler type thing, you know?
Rick Mercer's Monday Report returns at a new time.
Now at 9.
Why do you think people get together and watch it?
It's an excuse to drink and party.
Monday night on CBC.
For many, Tuesday will be a wake-up call. For some, the end of the dream.
He's got to watch his passivity.
Passivity? Is that like he's a fraidy cat?
I want to be out there so bad.
You're cut.
Making the Cut, presented by Bell. Tuesday on CBC.
Why play your way to the Grey Cup when Subway Restaurants is giving away 5 trips to the big game? Come in, then enter online. Plus, with any Lay's potato chip purchase, you get another chance to win from Subway.
Pontiac drivers don't break the law. They just get out of the way a lot better. Introducing Pontiac Wave.
Whew. With all this work to do, I'm glad you're here. Where are all your tools?
Right here.
It's the new Mastercraft Maximum Spin Saw that we found at Canadian Tire.
It's really 6 tools in one. It does it all.
Its variable speed motor suits any material, like drywall and ceramic wall tile. and you can use it as a scroll saw. With the router base and the cutting guide, you can make perfectly straight cuts, then adjust the base at an angle for beautiful beveled cuts.
It's also a terrific plunge router. Just push and cut a groove, or use it to add that decorative touch. This circle guide helps you cut perfect circles, while the lighted flex shaft attachment is ideal for fine detail work.
What's more, the new spin saw is also a grinder, a sander, and a saw.
We've done everything.
I told you, it does it all.
The new Mastercraft Maximum Spin Saw, only $149.99. Now that's different, and only at Canadian Tire. I'll start
with you. Growing up, Sonny was always so happy. He loved spending time with his daddy and me. But then he changed. He started hanging around with the wrong crowd, always staying out late. Then one day, I heard him talking to his friends about
mushrooms.
When we were kids, we didn't even know what Nintendo was. Sorry.
Introducing Gluckstein Home.
I've created five distinctive lifestyle collections, carefully designed to give your home elegance and sophistication. Great style, affordable luxury. More than you came for
at the bay. Will my car be ready this afternoon like you promised?
Yes.
Do you guarantee all your work, even general maintenance?
Yes.
Winter can be rough on your car, so protect it now with our winter maintenance package. Get an oil change, battery and antifreeze tests, tire rotation, and more for just $39.
Trust the Midas touch.
They got a body, they got a stretcher.
A new political thriller.
From now on, I call the shots.
H2O, starting Sunday, October 31st on CBC.
The Greatest Canadian is brought to you in part by Air Canada, and by Subway Restaurants. Subway, eat fresh.
Okay, we're back. Have you started arguing yet about who's on that top 10 list? Well, don't fight, vote. Here's how it works. In the coming weeks, on Mondays and Wednesdays at 8 p.m., 8:30 in Newfoundland, each of the top 10 great Canadians you nominated will be the feature of a Take No Prisoners special program, pleading and cajoling for your vote. The starting gun goes off tomorrow when George Strombolopoulos presents his pitch for Greatest Canadian, Tommy Douglas. Voting opens with that show. You can vote tomorrow night and after every one of the 10 shows. After each show, you can vote for anyone on the top 10 list, not just the person featured that night. You can vote online, by phone. You can even vote by text messaging. For all the rules about voting, go to cbc.ca/greatest. Get out there and vote. Get your friends to vote too. The great 6-week search for the greatest Canadian begins. See you tomorrow night.